विनोद सिंगला फ्रॉम हिसार एंड माई केस इज 63 ईयर फीमेल वॉज अ हाइपरटेंशिव एंड शी हैड पोस्ट पीटीसी टू ऑस्टल सर्क अबाउट 7 मंथ बैक विद 3/28 डैश विच वॉज पोस्ट डायलेटेड विद 3.5 एन सी बैलून. सो इट वॉज डन एल्सवेयर एंड सी प्रेजेंटेड टू मी विद चेस्ट पेन सिंस लास्ट 10 डेज. ट्रोप वॉज पॉजिटिव एंड ई सी जी एंड इको वर नॉट रिमार्केबल. सो So, did a check angiogram which showed there was a critical ISR of circumflex ostia. So, what we learned from last case was it should always be a crossover from LM to circ. But it was done at ostial circ, so there was critical stenosis and distal left main and ostial LAD also showed mild disease. So, my plan was to do a imaging from circumflex. So, first edge lesion was critical, so I did a pre-dilatation at LCX ostia with 3.5 NC balloon, 3 × 12 NC balloon. This was the result post-dilatation. Then I did imaging from circumflex side. We showed there was a lipid-rich plaque in the circumflex stent, and though MSA was more than 5. And there was ostial malposition also, 1 to 2 studs were hanging into left main. Then we did again from LAD side, which showed there was LAD ostia was also diseased, and there was disease in distal left main with the percentage plaque burden of more than 50%. So possibly that was the reason that distal left main had was diseased and stent was not done from LM to LAD, LM to circumflex. So that could be the main cause of the ISR. So here we were dealing with the ostial circumflex ISR with the ostial LAD mild disease and distal left main about 50% plaque burden. So plan was from LM to circumflex stenting. So did a dash 3.5 × 28. 3 LM to circumflex, did a port with 5 × 8 NC, and this was the result after port. So we thought of recrossing towards LAD to open the strut of towards LAD. So circumflex wire was crossed into LAD and 3.5 balloon went easily into LAD, such to there was no abluminal wiring. So did a high pressure circumflex kissing balloon and then did a FKVI with 3.5 balloon both in LAD and circumflex. But after that something fishy happened and possibly there was a deformation of the left main stent. First we checked the flow. Flow was okay, TME3 in both. So I did a IVUS from circumflex side. I was sure there was a possibly crumpling and fracture of the stent. There was we can show that there is layering of the stent struts. So what next? Other plan could be one more stent from LM to circ. That there could be three. Already there were two layers. So at LAD ostia was also disease. So we thought of putting a stent from LM to LAD, more like a double kissing pilot. So 4 × 15 dash was deployed from LM to LAD. This was the result after stenting LM to LAD. Then did a port by 5 × 8 balloon and again LAD wire was pushed towards circumflex and to prevent abluminal wiring, and then again did a FKBI with balloon of 4 in LAD and 3.5 in circumflex, and then did a report. These were the final views after report. That is showing TME3 flow in both LAD and circumflex. These were the final angios, LA caudal view showing good TME3 flow and we did again I was both from circumflex side and from LED side. These are the scene showing the crumpling of the stunt, like, and post after finishing of the case, there was like good carina was found. So there was a circumflex to LMCA pullback, which showed there was a good opposition of the stunt in the circumflex, and good POC was found, and stunt in LMCA was also opposed. These are the IVUS images, and LED. This was then pullback was also taken from LED, and there was a good POC in both from circumflex ostia and LED ostia. So take home message was, this ostial LED and circ lesions are seldom isolated. In most of the cases, distal LMCA is also involved. So we should always do a crossover instead of doing a ostial stenting. To open the side bed, side branch stud is routinely a matter of debate. We were also thinking that we must have left at that point only doing LM2 circumflex, and not have dilated LED, not have done FKBI. So also the reason for stunt deformation could be that we did a FKBI maybe at high pressure, though we did at 8 to 10 mm only. So that could be the one cause of stunt deformation. So we should be gentle doing FKBI. And you should also know the expansion limit of the DICU deploy. Thank you.